Thrips are a group of insects that attack cotton, and they're a perennial pest. Our producers have to deal with this group of insects every year. Thrips can cause significant injury if a preventative material is not used. Those include seed treatments, in-furrow granular materials, in-furrow liquid materials, and all those materials provide systemic protection from thrips under optimal growing conditions. A right amount of moisture, the right amount of heat, and if those are off, the systemic nature of the insecticide is not optimally taken into the plant and doesn't provide control of thrips. What we've had this year, we've had a lot of rain that has made those systemic materials leach out of the ground and not be optimally taken into the plants. We've had a lot of thrips injury this year. Temik is very effective, but it's in short supply and it's not being manufactured. So that's probably not going to be a viable option in the future. Thimet is another granular material that continues to be manufactured. It's readily available. It provides control of thrips in furrow, but it does not provide control of nematodes. That's the kind of control we got from Temik, both thrips and nematodes. The in-furrow liquid products that we have, one of the predominant ones that we're investigating is imidacloprid. Looks very good in furrow. We're looking at a 9-ounce rate of imidacloprid, and it looks really good for thrips. Again, no control of nematodes. So there's kind of a dual issue here with control of nematodes and thrips with a lot of these at-plant options, and that was pretty much started with Temik, Aldicarb, as that's a 40-year-old product, and folks have gotten used to managing both thrips and nematodes at planting. Now it's a little more difficult with the removal of that product from our systems. Well, as you can see here, we're next to a pair of plots where we have untreated plants that receive nothing at plant for preventative protection from thrips. And right next to that, the row adjacent to that is a seed treatment. This particular seed treatment has chemical thiamethoxam and is a common seed treatment used in the industry. And just a seed treatment, no foliar protection versus untreated. You can see the extensive injury on this cotton planted on the 15th of May. Extensive injury from thrips and what a seed treatment did here in sunny South Carolina in 2013. So here we are by another pair of plots where we have untreated plants right here beside me. And over to my right, we have another preventative at-plant treatment for thrips. This one happens to be imidacloprid in furrow at 9 ounces. Also a very good at-plant option for thrips versus doing nothing. All right, here we are next to another pair of plots. I am sitting next to untreated row, and right next to me is a plot protected with one of our growers' favorite chemicals of all time, Aldicarb, Temik, showing very good protection against thrips, in contrast to doing nothing for thrips in an untreated situation. Here we are again in another pair of plots demonstrating untreated protection from thrips and another granular material that is labeled for use on thrips preventatively, Thimet. So this is Thimet versus untreated and doesn't look as good as the Temik, but it's a very good option for our producers for thrips. When making a treatment decision with foliar insecticides for thrips, after an at-plant treatment is applied, the plants are actively growing, and you're starting to show signs of injury from thrips, I use one of two methods. I use a nice big white cup to shake the plants inside and dislodge the thrips for counting, or some sort of dark cloth that enables you to see the immatures easily on the cloth. Using a couple of these different methods when you're walking through a field and sampling numerous plants will give you a pretty good idea of the density of thrips on your cotton crop. In addition to using these two sampling methods, I like to visually inspect the terminal growth of cotton. If you're looking at the new growth, the new leaves that are coming out of the meristem, you can easily see the thrips injury, the crinkling of the leaves, the silvering sheen that's left by the feeding. And if you start to see an excessive amount of feeding there, that's also an indication that your at-plant treatment has played out and it's time to intervene with a chemical foliar insecticide. And to summarize, thrips are an important group of insects that attack cotton. They cost our producers millions of dollars each year in control cost. So you want to be timely with foliar insecticides applied after at-plant materials are played out on those plants. So please consult our most updated recommendations for controlling thrips.